My name is Nick Flores. I work at G Aviation here in Cincinnati, Ohio, and I'm a lead engineer. If you look up in the sky and you see a plane flying overhead, and you look at the engines, chances are those are made by GE Aviation. We make engines for commercial and military applications.
We have a very big responsibility. At any moment, there are many people flying in the sky. And as we say here at GE, it is our job to lift people up and bring them home safely.
At GE Aviation, mechanical engineers design all of the parts that you see on a jet engine. Basically, it all starts with an idea or a concept.
We start with like a conceptual design, which is pretty much you have a blank sheet of paper, you have requirements, you do hand calculations. Once you get through that process, you go to the next level, which is computer modeling and analysis. Essentially, you're taking something from paper and trying to make it a physical part and make sure that it fits in the engine and it works properly.
I work on the stress analysis team. So the main part of my job is to meet with the design team to make sure I understand under what conditions this part is going to be working and operating. I put all of this into a computer program that will try to simulate what happens in the field. Once we do this, we have all of these results. I have to make sure that they make sense. Yes, this is exactly what I would expect from this part working under these conditions.
And then you take all the results and those calculations and present them to our chief engineers, get them to agree that it is indeed a good design. And then you take it to the manufacturing facility and you work with them to ensure that it gets made exactly like you need it to be made. As a mechanical engineer, my day can vary greatly. But in general, one of the things we have a lot are meetings. With a complex machine like a jet engine, you constantly are working with different people and you have to make sure that you're all on the right course. One of the other things is to document the work that you did. You have to be able to put in a presentation or a written form what you did, why you did it, and what the results were. And the other thing I always try to do is get out to the shop floor. See the hardware, try to identify any issues that you can't necessarily find looking at a computer screen.
Every day I come to work with a different challenge. My days are not always the same, and I love that. I love to be challenged. It's very fast-paced. We commit to dates. We have to make it work, make it happen, and make it right. Once you create something, your name is on it, and you see this huge, complicated system working together. It's just like you get a thrill out of it. That's just what makes mechanical engineering so epic.
When I was a kid, growing up in Cuba, every time an airplane flew by, I told my friends, you know, one day I want to design one of those. And they would just laugh at me. Since then, I wanted to prove to myself that I could do it. And I never quit on it, and here I am.
As a kid, I'd find different things that were being thrown away, and I'd take it apart, try to see, what does this part do? What does it look like? I think that helped put me on that path to becoming an engineer.
I was a very curious girl. I always tried to understand how everything was put together. When I came from Ecuador, I had a friend that was like turboing his car and like making modifications. I got really interested in that, and I went to a junkyard with a friend and we got a motorcycle engine. We took it apart, tried to figure out why everything was done a certain way. And that's when I kind of realized that engineering was my thing. I did an internship at Cummins Diesel Engines. That was something that really helped me out by getting that experience while I was in college. I got my bachelor's in mechanical engineering, and I'll be going to Ohio State to get my master's in mechanical engineering.
Computer classes were some of my favorite classes when I was in high school. I actually got my associate degree in computer science. My first internship was a small company that built seats and interiors for private jets. After that, I went back to school, got my bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering, and I am actually working on my master's degree on aerospace engineering.
I got my Bachelor of Science in mechanical engineering, and after that, I joined the GE Edison Engineering Development Program, where they gave me the opportunity to get my Master's of Science in mechanical engineering. I started my career at GE Oil and Gas, and I love my time there. But after a few years, I started to think maybe I needed a different type of challenge. So I decided to join GE Aviation. I love engineering more than ever now. For a mechanical engineer, GE Aviation is like working at Candyland. It's the highest form of mechanical engineering there is. You start from scratch, do all the calculations using the best software to design one of the most complex machines on the planet, and then you see it come to life. That's a great reason to wake up every day.